Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Chapter number 5, the halogens and the noble gases. Question number 6, exercise. What are disproportionation reactions? Explain your answer with an example. A reaction in which a species, molecule, atom or ion is simultaneously oxidized and reduced is called disproportionation reaction. Example, 2NaOH plus chlorine, Cl2 at 15 degrees Celsius when heated. NaCl gives us NaCl salt. NaClO plus H2O plus water. This reaction is a disproportionation reaction because the zero oxidation state of chlorine atom in Cl2 is converted to negative 1 in chloride and plus 1 in hypochloride. Disproportionation reaction. A reaction in which a species, molecule, atom or ion is simultaneously oxidized. Disproportionation reaction. For example, NaOH plus chlorine gives us NaCl and NaClO plus water. NaOH plus Cl2 at 15 degrees Celsius, NaCl plus NaClO plus H2O. This reaction is a disproportionation reaction because the zero oxidation state of chlorine atom in chlorine is converted to negative 1 in chloride and plus 1 in hypochlorite. What are disproportionation reactions? Explain your answer with an example. Disproportionation reactions are those, a reaction in which a species, atom or molecule, atom or ion is simultaneously oxidized and reduced is called disproportionation reaction. 2NaOH plus chlorine at 15 degrees Celsius gives us NaCl plus NaClO plus water. This reaction is a disproportionation reaction because the zero oxidation state of chlorine atom in Cl2 is converted to negative 1 in chloride and plus 1 in hypochloride. Negative 1 in chloride and plus 1 in hypochloride, negative 1 in sodium chloride. Is negative 1 in sodium chloride and plus 1 in hypochlorite. Disproportionation reactions are a reaction in which a species, molecule, atom or ion is simultaneously oxidized and reduced is called disproportionation reaction. NaOH plus Cl2 at 15 degrees Celsius when heated gives us NaCl and NaClO plus water. This reaction is a disproportionation reaction because the zero oxidation state of chlorine atom in chlorine is converted to negative 1 in chloride and plus 1 in hypochloride. A reaction in which a species, molecule, atom or ion is simultaneously oxidized and reduced is called disproportionation reaction. 2NaOH plus Cl2 at 15 degrees Celsius gives us NaCl plus NaClO plus water. This reaction is disproportionation reaction because the zero oxidation state of chlorine atom in Cl2 is converted to negative 1 in chloride and plus 1 in hypochloride. A reaction in which a species, molecule, atom or ion is simultaneously oxidized and reduced is called disproportionation reaction. 2NaOH aqueous plus chlorine gas at 15 degrees Celsius when heated NaCl gives us NaCl plus NaClO plus H2O. This reaction is a disproportionation reaction because the zero oxidation state of chlorine atom in Cl2 is converted to negative 1 in chloride and plus 1 in hypochloride. What are disproportionation reactions? Explain your answer with an example. A reaction in which a species, molecule, atom or ion is simultaneously oxidized and reduced is called disproportionation reaction. 2NaOH plus Cl2 at 15 degrees Celsius gives us NaCl plus NaClO plus water. This reaction is a disproportionation reaction because the zero oxidation state of chloride, atom in Cl2 is converted to negative 1 in chloride and plus 1 in hypochloride. A reaction in which a species, molecule, atom or ion is simultaneously oxidized and reduced is called a disproportionation reaction. For example, 2NaOH plus Cl2 at gaseous form at 15 degrees Celsius gives us NaCl plus NaClO plus water. This reaction is a disproportionation reaction because the zero oxidation state of chlorine is converted into negative one, converted to negative one in chloride and plus one in hypochlorite. Question number 7. How halogen acids are ionized in water? Halogen acids are ionized in water. When halogen acids are dissolved in water, they undergo ionization as follows. HX plus H2O ionization gives us H3O positive plus X minus. Halogen acids donate a proton to H2O. As a result, H3O positive and X minus ions are formed. The extent of ionization of different halogen acids is in the following order. HF is smaller than HCl, HBr, HCl is smaller than HBr, HBr is smaller than HI. HF has exceptionally small extent of ionization due to hydrogen bonding. How halogen acids are converted in ionized into water? When halogen acids are dissolved in water, they undergo ionization as follows. HX is plus H2O ionizes to give H3O positive plus X minus. Halogen acid donates a proton to H2O. As a result, H3O positive and X minus ions are formed. The extent of ionization of different halogen acids is in the following order. HF is smaller than HCl, is smaller than HBr, and smaller than HI. The extent of ionization of different halogen acids is in the following order. Ionization. That means HI is easily ionized because its outermost electronic cloud, the electronic cloud of HI is larger, so nuclear charge, the effective nuclear charge is less in HI. The effective nuclear charge does not have control over the valence electrons compared to HBr, compared to HCl, and compared to fluorine, HF. HF has exceptionally small extent of ionization due to hydrogen bonding. HF has exceptionally small extent of ionization due to hydrogen bonding. When halogen acids are dissolved in water, they undergo ionization as follows. HX plus H2O. HX donates its H positive to form H3O positive and X minus ions. Halogen acids donate a proton to H2O. As a result, H3O positive and X minus ions are formed. The extent of ionization of different halogen acids is in the following order. HF is smaller than HCl, smaller than HBr, smaller than HI. HF has exceptionally small extent of ionization due to hydrogen bonding. How halogen acids are ionized in water? When they are reacted with water, they donate their proton to form H3O positive and X minus ions. The extent of ionization of different halogen acids is in the following order. Why HF is weaker than HCl? Question number 8. HF is weaker than HCl. Weaker acid than HCl. A substance which has tendency to give proton in an aqueous solution is called an acid. The strength of an acid is directly proportional to its proton releasing power. In HF, strong hydrogen bonding is present and partial positive hydrogen atom is entrapped between two strong and electronegative fluorine atoms. Consequently, if it becomes difficult for proton to be ionized in water, which makes it weak acid. A substance which has tendency to give proton in an aqueous solution is called an acid. The strength of an acid is directly proportional to its proton releasing power. In HF, strong hydrogen bonding is present and partial positive hydrogen atom is entrapped between two strong electronegative fluorine atoms. Consequently, it becomes difficult for proton to be ionized in water, which makes it weak acid. On the other hand, in HCl, dipole-dipole interaction is present, which is weaker than hydrogen bonding. Therefore, proton releases power of HCl. Proton H positive releasing power of HCl is more, which makes it strong acid. HF is weaker acid than HCl. A substance which has a tendency to give proton in an aqueous solution is called acid. The strength of an acid is directly proportional to its proton H positive releasing power. In HF, strong hydrogen bonding is present and partial positive hydrogen is an atom is entrapped between two strong electronegative fluorine atoms. Consequently, it becomes difficult for a proton to be ionized in water, which makes it weak acid. On the other hand, in HCl, dipole-dipole interactions is present, which is weaker than hydrogen bonding. Therefore, proton releasing power of HCl is more, which makes it strong acid. A substance which has tendency to give proton H positive in aqueous solution is called acid. The substance of an acid is directly proportional to the proton releasing power. In HF, strong hydrogen bonding is present and partial positive hydrogen atom is entrapped between two strong electronegative fluorine atoms. Consequently, it becomes difficult for proton to be ionized in water, which makes it a weak acid. Hydrogen is entrapped between two powerful electronegative atoms, so that's why it becomes difficult for a proton to be ionized in water, which makes it a weak acid. Next question, question number 9. In the following set, arrange the substances in order of increasing acidic character. Give reason. HClO, HClO2, HClO3, HClO4. Increasing acidic character. HClO is smaller than HClO2, smaller than HClO3, smaller than HClO4. Reason: the strength of oxy acids of halogens increases with increase in number of oxygen atoms. The strength of oxy acids of halogen increases with increase in number of oxygen atoms. As the oxidation state of halogen atom in oxy acids increases, the bonding electrons are shifted away from hydrogen atom and the tendency of molecules to lose proton increases. This accounts for the increasing the strength of oxy acids, thus increasing order of acidic strength of oxy acids as HClO smaller than HClO2, smaller than HClO3, smaller than HClO4. The strength of oxy acids of halogens increases with increase in number of oxygen atoms. As the oxidation state of halogen atoms in oxy acids increases, the bonding electrons are shifted away from hydrogen atom and the tendency of molecules to lose proton increases. This accounts for increasing the strength of oxy acids. Thus, increasing order of acidic strength of oxy acids is HClO greater than HClO2, HClO3, HClO4. The strength of oxy acids of halogens increases with increase in number of oxygen atoms. As the oxidation state of halogen atom in oxy acids increases, the bonding electrons are shifted away from hydrogen atom. And the tendency of molecules to lose proton increases. This accounts for increasing the strength of oxy acids. Thus, increasing order of acidic strength of oxy acids is HClO smaller than HClO2, smaller than HClO3, smaller than HClO4. Acidic strength कौन अपने प्रोटॉन्स को रिलीज करता है उसी को एसिड कहते हैं जैसे कि ऊपर पढ़ा है. अ सब्सटेंस विच हैज अ टेंडेंसी टू गिव प्रोटॉन इन एन एक्वस सॉल्यूशन इज कॉल्ड एन एसिड. तो द स्ट्रेंथ ऑफ एन एसिड इज डायरेक्टली प्रोपोर्शनल टू द प्रोटॉन टू इट्स प्रोटॉन रिलीजिंग पावर टू द तो सबसे ज्यादा प्रोटॉन रिलीजिंग पावर HClO4 के पास है. द स्ट्रेंथ ऑफ ऑक्सी एसिड्स ऑफ हैलोजन इंक्रीजेज विद इंक्रीज इन नंबर ऑफ ऑक्सीजन एटम्स. एज द ऑक्सीडेशन स्टेट ऑफ हैलोजन एटम इन ऑक्सी एसिड्स इंक्रीजेज द बॉन्डिंग इलेक्ट्रॉन्स आर शिफ्टेड अवे फ्रॉम हाइड्रोजन एटम एंड टेंडेंसी ऑफ मॉलिक्यूल्स टू लूज प्रोटॉन इंक्रीजेज. This accounts for increasing the strength of oxy acids, thus increasing order of acidic strength of oxy acids is HClO smaller than HClO2, HClO3 smaller than HClO4. the strength of oxy acids of halogen increases with increase in number of oxygen atoms. As the oxidation state of halogen atom in oxy acids increases, the bonding electrons are shifted away from hydrogen atom and tendency of molecules to lose proton increases. This accounts for increasing the strength of oxy acids. This thus increasing order of acidic strength of oxy acids is HClO, smaller than HClO2, smaller than HClO3, smaller than HClO4. The strength of oxy acids of halogen increases with increase in number of oxygen atoms. As the oxidation state of halogen atom in oxy acids increases, the bonding electrons are shifted away from the hydrogen atom. The bonding electrons are shifted away from hydrogen atom and the tendency of molecules to lose proton increases. This accounts for increasing the strength of oxy acids. Thus, increasing order of acidic strength of oxy acids is HClO, smaller than HClO2, smaller than HClO3, smaller than HClO4. The strength of oxy acids of halogen increases with the increase in number of oxygen atoms. As the oxidation state of halogen atom in oxy acids increases, then bonding electrons are shifted away from hydrogen atom and tendency of molecules to lose proton increases. This accounts for increasing the strength of oxy acid, thus increasing order of acidic strength of oxy acids is HClO, smaller than HClO2, smaller than HClO3, smaller than HClO4. Acidic character is in this form. How? Because as the number of oxygen increases, the strength of oxy acids of halogens increases with increase in number of oxygen atoms. The strength of oxy acids increases with increase in number of oxygen atoms. As the oxidation state of halogen atom in oxy acids increases, the bonding electrons are shifted away from hydrogen atom, Cl. Cl के ऊपर जैसे जैसे oxidation state उसकी बढ़ती जाती है, तो यहाँ से bonding electrons hydrogen से move करते जाते हैं, दूर होते जाते हैं, atom hydrogen away, shifted away from hydrogen atom and tendency of molecules lose proton increases. और tendency of electrons लूज करने की प्रोटॉन के वो बढ़ जाती है. दिस अकाउंट्स फॉर इंक्रीजिंग द स्ट्रेंथ ऑफ ऑक्सी एसिड्स. दस इंक्रीजिंग ऑर्डर ऑफ एसिडिक स्ट्रेंथ ऑफ ऑक्सी एसिड्स इज HClO, स्मॉलर देन HClO2, स्मॉलर देन HClO3, स्मॉलर देन HClO4. जैसे ही ऑक्सीजन का नंबर बढ़ता है ऑक्सी एसिड्स के अंदर, एज द स्ट्रेंथ ऑफ ऑक्सी एसिड्स ऑफ हैलोजेंस इंक्रीजेज विद इंक्रीज इन नंबर ऑफ ऑक्सीजन एटम्स. द स्ट्रेंथ ऑफ ऑक्सी एसिड्स ऑफ हैलोजेंस The strength of oxy acids of halogens increases with increase in number of oxygen atoms. As the oxidation state of halogen atom in oxy acids increases, the bonding electrons are shifted away from hydrogen atom and tendency of molecule to lose proton increases. This accounts for increasing the strength of oxy acid, thus increasing the order of acidic strength of oxy acids. Oxy acid is HClO, smaller than HClO2, smaller than HClO3, smaller than HClO4. In the following set arranged, the substances in order of increasing acidic strength give reason: HClO, HClO2, HClO3, HClO4. Increasing acidic strength, acidic character is tarah hai ki HClO, HClO2, HClO3, HClO4. HClO4 सबसे ज़्यादा acidic character है, सबसे ज़्यादा जल्दी अपना proton donate कर सकता है. उसकी वजह यह है कि oxygen जैसे बढ़ता है तो oxy acids की strength बढ़ती है. जो जब strength बढ़ती है तो number of oxygen atoms increases. The strength of oxy acids of halogens increases. As the oxidation state of halogen atom in oxy acids increases, the bonding electrons are shifted away from hydrogen atom and tendency of molecule to lose proton increases. This accounts for increasing the strength of oxy acid, thus increasing order of acidic strength of oxy acids is HClO, HClO2, HClO3, HClO4. The strength of oxy acids of halogen increases with increase in number of oxygen atoms. As the oxidation state of halogen atom in oxy acids increases, the bonding electrons are shifted away from hydrogen atom and tendency of molecules to lose proton increases. This accounts for increasing the strength of oxy acids. this accounts for increasing the strength of oxy acids. The strength of oxy acids of halogens. The strength of oxy acids of halogens increases with increase in number of carbon atoms. As the oxidation state of halogen atom in oxy acids increases, the bonding electrons are shifted away from hydrogen atom, and tendency of molecules to lose proton increases. This accounts for the increasing the strength of oxy acid. This thus increasing order of acidic strength of oxy acids is HClO, smaller than HClO2, smaller than HClO3, smaller than HClO4. HClO, जैसे जैसे ऑक्सीजन बढ़ता है तो स्ट्रेंथ ऑफ ऑक्सी एसिड्स ऑफ हैलोजन बढ़ती है. ऑक्सीडेशन जैसे जैसे क्लोरीन बढ़ता जाएगा, जैसे जैसे ऑक्सीडेशन क्लोरीन का बढ़ता जाएगा, वैसे वैसे जो बॉन्डेड इलेक्ट्रॉन है हाइड्रोजन के साथ वो शिफ्ट होकर क्लोरीन पे आता जाएगा, जिसकी वजह से एसिडिक स्ट्रेंथ बढ़ती जाएगी. जैसे जैसे ऑक्सीजन का कैरेक्टर इंक्रीजिंग ऑर्डर, जैसे जैसे एसिडिक कैरेक्टर बढ़ता जाएगा, जैसे जैसे स्ट्रेंथ बढ़ती जाएगी ऑक्सी एसिड्स की. इसी तरह नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन, क्वेश्चन नंबर 10. What happens when bleaching powder reacts with dilute H2SO4 and NH3? When bleaching powder reacts with dilute H2SO4, yani CaCl2, bleaching powder with dilute H2SO4, kya deta hai? It gives us hypochlorous acid. It gives us hypochlorous acid, calcium sulfate, yani CaSO4 and CaCl2, CaSO4 and CaCl2 plus HClO, hypochlorous acid. It gives us CaSO4, CaCl2, HClO. Bleaching powder oxidizes ammonia to nitrogen. Oxidize कर देना, removal of hydrogen. Oxidizes ammonia to nitrogen. Bleaching powder oxidizes ammonia to nitrogen. 3CaOCl2 plus 2NH3 gives us CaCl2, 3H2O plus N2. CaCl2 and H2O plus N. H2O plus N, CaCl2, H2O plus N. Bleaching powder oxidizes ammonia to nitrogen. What happens when bleaching powder reacts with dilute H2SO4 and NH3? When it reacts with dilute H2SO4, hypochlorous acid is formed, and when it reacts with ammonia, it oxidizes ammonia to nitrogen. Bleaching powder is CaOCl2 plus H2SO4 and plus NH3. When reacts with CaOCl2 CaSO4 plus HClO plus calcium sulfate, calcium chloride, and hypochlorous acid is HClO. CaOCl2 plus H2SO4 gives us calcium sulfate and calcium chloride and HClO, hypochlorous acid. When bleaching powder oxidizes ammonia to nitrogen. CaOCl2, which is bleaching powder, reacts with ammonia and converts ammonia to nitrogen, and H2O water is formed, and CaCl2 is formed. Calcium chloride in solid form is formed right here, and calcium chloride aqueous is formed in the above equation. When bleaching powder reacts with dilute H2SO4, it forms hypochlorous acid, that is HClO. 2CaOCl2, calcium bleaching powder. Bleaching powder, what happens when bleaching powder reacts with dilute H2SO4 and NH3? when it reacts with dilute H2SO4, it forms calcium sulfate and calcium chloride and hypochlorous acid. When it reacts with NH3, it forms nitrogen and it forms calcium chloride solid and water. Calcium chloride solid, water and nitrogen. Calcium chloride solid, water and nitrogen, where in the above equation calcium sulfate and calcium chloride aqueous plus calcium chloride aqueous plus hypochlorous acid, that is HClO. CaOCl2 plus H2SO4 gives us CaOCl2 plus H2SO4 gives us CaSO4 plus CaCl2 plus hypochlorous acid, that is HClO. When it reacts with ammonia, it gives us it oxidizes ammonia to nitrogen. So water is formed water is formed, nitrogen is formed, and CaCl2, calcium chloride, water and nitrogen is formed. CaOCl2 plus ammonia gives us calcium chloride plus water plus nitrogen. CaOCl2 plus NH2 gives us CaCl2 plus H2O plus nitrogen. When bleaching powder reacts with dilute H2SO4, it gives hypochlorous acid. 2CaOCl2 plus dilute H2SO4 gives us calcium sulfate, calcium chloride, HClO, that is hypochlorous acid. Bleaching powder oxidizes ammonia to nitrogen. CaOCl2 plus NH2 gives us CaCl2 plus H2O plus N. H2O plus N. N2 plus N2. What happens when bleaching powder reacts with dilute H2SO4 and NH3? When it reacts with dilute H2SO4, it gives us hypochlorous acid, calcium chloride, and calcium sulfate. When it reacts with when bleaching powder reacts with ammonia, it oxidizes ammonia to nitrogen N2, and it gives us calcium chloride, and it gives us water. Calcium chloride and water. Next question, question number 11. What happens when bleaching powder reacts with excess of concentrated H2SO4 and carbon dioxide? If excess of an acid, weak or strong, is added to bleaching powder, chlorine is given out. CaOCl2 plus H2SO4 gives us CaSO4 plus H2O plus chlorine. It's concentrated H2SO4 here. If excess of an acid is added to bleaching powder, chlorine is given out. CaOCl2, CaSO4, then H2O and Cl2, gaseous form. Cl2 gaseous form, chlorine is given out. Bleaching powder reacts with carbon dioxide to form calcium carbonate and release chlorine. What happens when bleaching powder reacts with excess of concentrated H2SO4 and carbon dioxide? They both release when bleaching powder, that is CaOCl2 when reacts with H2SO4 concentrated, Cl2 is formed. Cl2 gaseous is formed and released, and same with the case when reacts with carbon dioxide. When CaOCl2 reacts with carbon dioxide, chlorine gas is released in the atmosphere. Bleaching powder reacts with carbon dioxide to form calcium carbonate and release chlorine. Calcium carbonate and chlorine. When bleaching powder reacts with excess of concentrated H2SO4 what happens, it forms CaSO4, CaSO4 water and C water and it's chlorine gas. When bleaching powder reacts with carbon dioxide, we get CaCO3 and Cl2 gaseous form. Next question. What is bleaching powder? Give its uses. What is bleaching powder and give its uses? What is bleaching powder? It is, its formula is CaOCl2. Its formula is CaOCl2. Give its uses. The chemical name of bleaching powder is calcium hypochlorite chloride. The bleaching powder, the chemical name of bleaching powder is calcium hypochlorite chloride. It is a yellowish powder with strong smell of chlorine. Bleaching powder is used for the preparation of chlorine and oxygen. It is used in the manufacture of chloroform as a disinfectant and for the sterilization of water, for making unshrinkable wool, to bleach cotton, linen and paper pulp. Delicated fibers like wool, silk, etc. cannot be bleached with it because they could be damaged by chlorine. The chemical name of bleaching powder is calcium hypochlorite chloride. It is a yellowish powder with strong smell of chlorine. Bleaching powder is used for the preparation of chlorine and oxygen. To bleach cotton, linen and paper pulp. For making unshrinkable wool as a disinfectant and for the sterilization of water. For the preparation of chlorine and oxygen. It is also used for the manufacture of chloroform as a disinfectant and for the sterilization of water, to make unshrinkable wool, to bleach cotton, linen and paper pulp. Delicated fibers like wool, silk, etc. cannot be bleached with it because they could be damaged by chlorine. Bleaching powder ke uses kya hai? Bleaching powder ka chemical naam hai calcium hypochlorite chloride. Uske baad ye yellowish form mein hota hai, strong smell hoti hai chlorine. With strong smell of chlorine, इसके अंदर small strong smell of chlorine होती है. Chlorine और oxygen को prepare करने में help करते हैं. It also helps in the manufacturing of CHCl3 यानी chloroform. Chloroform को बनाने में इस्तेमाल होते हैं और sterilization of water में इस्तेमाल होते हैं. And और क्या कहते हैं, to bleach cotton, linen and paper pulp. Delicate fibers cannot be bleached with it because they may be damaged by chlorine. Bleaching powder as a disinfectant and for sterilization of water. For making unshrinkable wool, to bleach cotton, linen and paper pulp, for making unshrinkable wool. The chemical name for bleaching powder is calcium hypochlorite chloride. It is a yellowish powder with strong smell of chlorine. Bleaching powder is used for the preparation of chlorine oxygen. It is also used for the manufacturing of chloroform as a disinfectant, for the sterilization of water, for making unshrinkable wool, to bleach cotton, linen and paper pulp. Delicate fibers like wool, silk, etc. cannot be bleached with it because they could be damaged by chlorine. MCQs. Hydrogen bond is the strongest between the molecules of HF. Which of the following is the strongest acid in solution? It's HI. HI is the strongest acid in solution because इसके दरमियान जो फोर्सेस होती हैं वो बहुत वीक होती हैं, जिसकी वजह से इनको तोड़ना इजी होता है, और एच जोन सा है हाइड्रोजन प्रोटॉन डोनेट करने में आसानी होती है इनको। जो ज़्यादा जल्दी प्रोटॉन डोनेट करते हैं वो ज़्यादा स्ट्रॉन्ग एसिड होते हैं, इसीलिए एक तो इसका इलेक्ट्रॉनिक क्लाउड भी बड़ा होता है और इसको तोड़ना, इसके अंदर से हाइड्रोजन को रिलीज़ करना वो भी ईजी होता है कंपेयर टू दूसरे हाइड्रोजन हैलाइड्स। तीसरा, डैश इज़ यूज एज कूलिंग मीडियम फॉर न्यूक्लियर रिएक्टर्स हीलियम। विच वन इज़ अ क्लोरस एसिड HClO? हाइड्रोजन बॉन्ड इज स्ट्रॉन्गेस्ट बिटवीन द मॉलिक्यूल्स ऑफ HF। HF के अंदर हाइड्रोजन बॉन्डिंग होती है, बहुत स्ट्रॉन्ग होती है, सबसे स्ट्रॉन्ग होती है, क्योंकि F का साइज भी स्मॉल होता है, F का साइज फ्लोरीन का साइज स्मॉल होता है। डैश हाइड्रोजन हैलाइड इज़ द वीकेस्ट एसिड इन सोल्यूशन। वीकेस्ट जो है वो हाइड्रोजन HF है, हाइड्रोजन हैलाइड जो है फ्लोराइड है HF है, क्योंकि HF के दरमियान स्ट्रॉन्ग बॉन्डिंग होती है, हाइड्रोजन बॉन्डिंग स्ट्रॉन्ग होती है, जिसकी वजह से इसको तोड़ना मुश्किल होता है और ये वीक एसिड होता है, यानी प्रोटॉन रिलीज जल्दी नहीं कर सकता। आउट ऑफ द एलिमेंट्स ऑफ ग्रुप 7A द हाइएस्ट मेल्टिंग एंड बॉइलिंग पॉइंट्स इज शोन बाई द एलिमेंट I2। I2 वो एलिमेंट है जो सबसे ज़्यादा हाइएस्ट मेल्टिंग एंड बॉइलिंग पॉइंट शो करता है, विच इज़ द स्ट्रॉन्गेस्ट एसिड HClO4, क्योंकि ये ज़्यादा जल्दी अपना हाइड्रोजन रिलीज कर सकता है। जैसे जैसे ऑक्सीजन बढ़ते जाएंगे स्ट्रॉन्ग होता जाएगा, ऑक्सी एसिड्स ऑफ हैलोजन स्ट्रॉन्ग होते जाएंगे, और जैसे जैसे स्ट्रॉन्ग होते जाएंगे तो जो बाउंडेड इलेक्ट्रॉन्स है वो मूव करते जाएंगे क्लोरीन के ऊपर और हाइड्रोजन से ख़त्म होते जाएंगे, तो ज़्यादा टेंडेंसी बढ़ जाती है हाइड्रोजन का निकल जाने की। द हैलोजन विच अकर्स नेचुरली इन अ पॉजिटिव ऑक्सीडेशन स्टेट इज आयोडीन। द एनहाइड्राइड ऑफ HClO4 इज Cl2O7।